Okay guys, now we will have a quick review about our diesel generator and all the training. So we will record this session, so in future we will see it again and we will work very easily. So first of all, here we have a complete generator set. Okay, as you know, generator is using to produce electricity. Okay, so in our generator we have some main components, and after coupling all these equipment together we are producing electricity. So the main equipment in the generator, we have diesel engine. Okay, so this is our diesel engine, and here we have our alternator, which is called AC alternator, which is used for producing electricity. Okay, here we have coupling. This is called coupling area. Okay, our engine is coupled with the alternator. Okay, engine is producing mechanical power, and after coupling this mechanical power with our alternator, it is producing the electricity. Okay, as I explain you, we are producing electromagnet in our alternator, and when this electromagnetic field, it's cutting the stator winding. Okay, so it is producing electricity as per Faraday law. Okay, so now here we have, first of all, in our generator, what are the systems? First system is fuel system, which, because we are giving fuel to the engine, and then engine having combustion inside, so it is making mechanical rotation of the crankshaft, and engine is providing a mechanical power on the our main flywheel. Okay, from where we have coupling our alternator. So in the fuel system, what we have, we are taking fuel from our main tank. Okay, we are taking fuel from our main tank, which is entering here in the fuel filter. Fuel filter is filtering the fuel and then giving us this fuel in the injection system. And once the injection fuel is injected and air is injected, they will make a combustion inside the chamber and it will make a mechanical rotation. So this is the first thing. Second thing, we have air system. Air system also, as I explained you, that mixture of fuel and air we are making, after that the combustion is happened. So where it is started, this is our main air filter. From here, air will be enter in the generator, okay, but it will get filtered. From filter, it will enter in the turbocharger and after cooler, and from after cooler, it is returning back in the air, in the engine, sorry. In engine, when it is enter, and it will get compressed with the fuel, so it will make a blast inside. Okay, so it will continuously, this process will happen, and it will run continuously running our generator. So this is related to mechanical part. So now what is this? This is called starter motor. Okay, starter motor is only using during the start of the generator, and it is connected with the two batteries, which is 24 volt here, two batteries 12 volt, which is connected in series to make 24 volt. Okay, these 24 volt are connected here on our main starter motor. Some of the wires are going to our control panel, and some of the wire coming from our DC charging alternator. DC charging alternator, after starting the engine, DC charging alternator will keep running our generator DC power, and plus it is charging the batteries. So only batteries are used in the starting of the generator. After that they are charging. So this starter motor only work only for 3 to 5 seconds in the starting. After that the circuit, the controller will cut off the circuit and it will stop. If it will continuously move with the engine at 1800 rpm, it is damaged, it is overheated, and you will see it the gear will be damaged or it will be overheated. Sometimes this is happen due to failure of any relay or any wire, it is happening. Okay, to protect this we are using overload fuses, okay, plus this kind of relay, but some, in case if the relay is failure or not change in the time, it will be damaged. But the function I explain you, it is only work for 2 to 3 seconds to just run the engine. After that, here we have ECM. This is called electronic control module, or ECU, engine control unit. All the engine protection are connected here, and after that this ECU is connected with our main controller, okay, which is there, which is for operator control. Okay, this ECU is belongs to the engine protection and plus the injection system control. Here inside the block we have 6 injectors. Okay, this 6 injector making firing order as per micro based controller. Okay, this ECU will give command to the 6 our fuel injectors, and they are working. Okay, so from this side it is okay regarding the fuel system, air system and ECU. Okay, now we'll go other side and we'll see what are the systems installed there. Okay, so let's go there. Okay guys, now here we have lubrication oil filter. This lubrication oil filter, because we are using inside the engine for engine lubrication engine oil, so engine oil should be clean by filter. So we installed one filter for continuously the circulation of oil will make get some carbon inside and some other particle material, so they stop and it will not rotate inside the engine again. Okay, so for that's why we are changing this filter every 250 hours. Fuel filter will be changed after every 250 hours. Oil filter will be changed after every 250 hours. Air filter will be changed 800 to 1000 hours, and also we can clean it on daily basis. After that, here we have, as you see, the main line from the air filter, which is distributed in two. Okay, and here we have two turbos. One turbo for three cylinder and one turbo for the other three cylinder. This is total 6 cylinder engine. Okay, this is Perkins 2800 series engine. Okay, and we have one common exhaust. Okay, one common exhaust with two silencer lines. Okay, so here after this we have this dipstick. From dipstick, with the help of dipstick, operator can check the oil level. This can be done daily. Okay, before starting we will remove, clean, put it again, then check the oil level. If the oil level is correct, we will run the engine. If oil level is not correct, we will not run. We will fill the oil, then we will run. Same water, we will check if the water level is low, or you are getting a signal low water level in the radiator, fill the coolant. Don't use tap water. Here we have oil valve. Always keep this valve closed. Only service technician, when they are doing service, they just open it, drain the engine oil, then close it, fill it and run again. But after checking the dipstick level, if the oil level is okay, we will run the engine. Water is okay, then we will run the engine. Air filter is fixed, we will run the engine. Any work which is uncompleted, we will not run the engine. Okay guys, after that here we have our alternator. Okay, in simple, this is 12 lead alternator. Okay, which is producing 400 volt line to line, 220 volt line to neutral, and this is coupling area. And here we have the air, the fan also, which is suck the air from the front grills and exhaust from here to keep it cool. So always don't put any plastic or cover with anything. This part should be open. Okay, otherwise it will make overheat our alternator. Here we have water jacket heater. Okay, this water jacket heater is working during the standby. For example, if one of the generator is working, so it will give power to this water jacket heater and keep the engine block water its heat in the heating state. Okay, around 50 degree or 25 to 50 degrees. Okay, so it will help us in soft starting. Okay, so next, now I will go on control panel and we will check the control area and what are the equipment necessaries installed here one by one. So we will check. Okay guys, here we have our control panel, main breaker, AVR, battery charger. Okay, battery charger is installed here. This is our three phases, red, yellow, blue. Okay, these cables are going in our totalizing panel. This is our main switch, main breaker. Okay, here we have generator power which is coming from the alternator. This is cutting the circuit, this breaker, and after that here we have our load. If this breaker is open, you are not able to operate any electrical loads because it is working like a gate. If gate is open, nothing will flow. If gate is closed, everything will be flow. So electricity will be flow if the gate is closed. Okay, AVR, automatic voltage regulator. This card is responsible to control the alternator voltage. If it is going up or down, this card will control and always give us stable voltage, because all the stability control, voltage control, it's built in this card. If this card is damaged, even sometime we don't have voltage, because this card is giving excitation to our alternator to produce the electricity. After that, here we have battery charger. This battery charger is different than dynamo. This charger only working when generator in standby mode and other generators are working. When this generator start working, it will stop this charger and it will shift on dynamo. This will only work when all the units are on and working. So the from power from other generator, this will on. This is also charger. This is called static battery charger. Okay. Here we have our main deep sea controller, which is master controller, operator controller. Okay. Which will help us starting, stopping, breaker control and synchronizing control. Okay. And also we have on the front module emergency stop. In case of any emergency, the operator or any person who don't know how to stop from here, he can stop from this switch. Now I will explain you what is inside the panel. Okay. Inside the panel, we have number of circuit breaker here. In application, they are same like this, but this is three pole and they are single pole. Each one you have see single wire, connected single wire. But here we have three wires. So this is three pole, this is single pole. Here we have three breaker for generator sensing, three breaker for bus sensing. After that, we have one breaker for battery charging, one breaker for water jacket heater, one breaker for dynamo, one breaker for main positive, and one breaker for the control. Okay, for the controller. Okay, so now the controller breakers are off and controller is off. In the same thing, we have three phase red, yellow, blue from generator, line 1, line 2, line 3. 1, 2, 3, line 1, line 2, line 3. Okay, one for battery charger, one for heater, one for controller, and this is also for one for dynamo, and one is sub breaker for this control system. Okay, if any one of this having problem or damage, you will face some alarm on your screen. Okay, so this is called relay. You can remove it like this. This is 11 pin relay. It's like an electromagnet switch. Our controller is operate ECM via this relay, because we are not connected directly our controller, because in case any short circuit happened, it will damage directly the controller. So in between we put this relay, so controller will only operate the relay, and inside the relay, if you see, we have a contact. Once the relay is energized, this relay work like this. See, it is moving contacts inside, so the power will flow. So our controller will operate only the relay coil, and relay coil will energize this contact, so the power will flow from here to our main ECU or ECM. So it will protect also our controller. So in this way, we have different relay for different application, like for fuel relay, like for starter motor, like for breaker control. AR means alarm relay, generator relay, JKR from breaker. Okay, MKR motor relay, start relay, SR means start relay. Okay, you can find all the details in the drawing which we submitted to you. Okay, so now we will turn on all the breakers. Okay, now we will turn on all the breaker. So now we will see the power is here in our controller. Okay, now it is showing generator at rest stop mode. So now we will make demonstration of starting, how to start, stop, and how to close the breaker. So I will close this. You are ready, na?
Ready, na?
Okay. So now we will start the genset. How we will start manually? We have to press first, select the manual mode, and then press green button. Already we check oil and water is okay. So now we are starting the engine. Okay. Now we'll press green button, so it's starting the engine now. Now
sir, will it stop?
Yeah. Actually, now,
2 minutes.
Yes, 2 minutes for cooling down. For example, once I open the breaker, it will operate 2 minutes without load to be get normalized and cooled down. Because I am working on load, now I am going to rest completely off. So slowly, I will come down. So here, if you bring it near, I will show you how we will use this meter. Here, first we will select voltage. Okay, here it is showing two line, straight line and this wave. Straight line means DC voltage, sinusoidal wave for AC voltage. Okay, I select on voltage first because I am checking voltage. Which voltage? AC voltage. So I select function button. It is showing now AC because I am going to check AC. So I select function AC. If I am checking battery, I will put function DC. Then it will check DC voltage. Never use DC or AC. Yani you are put DC here and checking AC, it will damage your meter. Okay? Mm-hmm. Be careful when you are using your meter. You must know how to use all these functions. So I will explain you now how to use. So now you see, once I operate manually, with first select manual button, then start button. Once generator is available here, I press this button. So it will on our breaker. And then we check the power here. It's available power. Before it is showing 0 volt. Input we have power. Once generator started, input we have power. So always when you are working in this area, wear gloves, electrical gloves, not the simple one. Okay? Always, because in case by mistake you touch any of the conductor, you will get electric shock. Okay, this is our DC charger. I have already explained you. Now we will see how to use this meter. Here we have range AC wave. This you have to remember, AC wave. Okay, for AC current always it's wave. For direct current DC, straight line. Okay, so here we have option for ampere 1000 to 600 till 600. We have two range here. Okay. So how we will check the ampere while running on load? Okay, if we have load, now we don't have load, so we are not able to check. But on load, select the range, AC range. Now we are checking AC. So just open this, press this, put it here. So you will know how much current is flowing from the generator. Okay, if we are checking battery amperage, so we will select here function DC. But this meter is not selecting range in DC because no mark here for DC. So we are not. So now we are not able to check DC here. That's why function is not changing. Okay. So here also we have AC DC voltage. Okay. You can check by AC DC. Okay. This is millivolt. If you are doing some electronic card checking, so you will check millivolts. Here we have three options: diode test, continuity and resistance test. Okay, if now it is auto mode. Okay, if I select the function, for example, now continuity, now I will check the continuity. It is showing that I am in continuity mode. Okay, now open. So now if I want to check the breaker, it is working, it is open or no? See, it is showing open. Close here. See, here it is open. Here it is open. Open means there is no circuit between now these two lines. Okay. Yeah, here why it is showing? Because this is commonly connected with all other generators. So neutral is connected. That's why. If it is a single generator, you remove the cable from here, you will see it is not showing any voltage. Okay. So now quickly you will check the battery voltage. How to check the battery voltage? Okay. Okay. Now set on DC. Okay, so if single battery how much voltage and double battery how much volt, now we will verify this. Okay, yeah, okay, bas enough. Look, now we are testing on one battery, so it is showing 13.16 volt. Okay, but here as you see it is a jumper. And it is going second cable here. If I check here, because these are two cable coming from directly from battery, so it will show us. Look,
now it is not connecting good, so that's why it's not showing voltage. I will connect. Okay, look, now it is showing 26 volt. Okay, if I'm not touching on the good conductive surface, it will not show you the voltage. So now it is showing 26 volt. Okay, because it is not touching here very good, there is a rust. Look, 26 volt. So this is the procedure to check AC and DC. Okay, so I think now if you have any question, you can ask us and we can wind up the training.